Hello friends, welcome to our website etltestingtutorial.com. Today I am going to start with the topic, what is testing? What are different kind of testing that we can perform within reports that we have generated, that we'll generate with the help of Tableau tool, right? So we have already covered what are reports, why we do need reports. Okay, so let's see that once we are able to create the graphical view of the data that we have created with the ETL process. This is the data after performing the ETL process with the Informatica tool. Now what we need? We do need to do analysis on that data, right? So analysis on that data can be possible if we have the reports, right? So BI analysis can be done with the reports. Reports means the graphical representation. Reporting can be implemented with the Tableau tool. In our case, we'll work with this tool. We have multiple options for that, right? So now, the reports, once we are able to generate, what is the next thing that we do need? We can do testing on that. Testing means to test what we are getting as the report, if it is correct or not. Multiple ways to test the report that we are getting. So these are the highlights of the reports. These are the highlights of the testing that we can perform. BI functional testing, ad hoc, stress. Within each and every testing, there are many ways to do the testing. Let me show you the ways. I have already created the Word file for that. So the very first kind of testing is functional testing. So within functional testing, we have the dashboard design check. So what is dashboard? Again, the thing is, once we create the report means a single sheet. But we may need to create the multiple sheets for different section of data. Like first one, I want to visualize my collected data within the graph chart. In the second way, I want to represent the same thing within the pie chart. We may want to represent the same thing with the graphical locations, like in Delhi or in India, in US, in UK, or maybe in the tree charts, right? So the collection of multiple reports will make one dashboard. And if I'm saying I'm going to test the dashboard, it means surely means multiple sheets, multiple reports will also be tested. Okay, so I'll check for the design that I am getting within dashboard if it is correct or not. We'll check for that. Design means the complete format that I am getting is correct or not. Maybe I want to implement this thing here before implementing the second thing, or I want second thing here, first thing, the last thing at the top. Okay, so this is something that comes under the design check. So what about prompt 6? Prompt means the filters like which I am setting. Prompts means when I click here once, which values we are getting within the prompt. Like sometimes in the website also, it create the prompts if you want to allow or if you don't want to allow. If you want to allow, then it will ask for your login ID and password, right? So those are the prompts. We'll check for that also. Report data accuracy. Accuracy of data is the must thing that we need. See, first two types of testing that I explain is something that is with the design part. That can be done by the user that who don't know about the data that is present inside that. Right, the data that is actually coming. The ones who don't know, one person who don't know can also do testing on the designing. But what about data? Data can be tested only if we have the knowledge. I'll give you one example on that. Let's say if this is my dashboard, and within this dashboard we have the pie chart representation of the data. Okay, and within that pie chart we have the data like this. Okay, I can't explain you here. Okay, because it should be done with the reporting tool only. Let's say 25 here, 50, 12, and here it's 13. So this is the pie chart representation. So complete should be 100, correct. So now the thing is, let's say this 50 this is surely the percentage part. Okay, if I'm working with the pie chart, we can implement this thing. So 50% of the data is coming from the data, like I'll take the same example. Like if we are working with the Jungle Lounge Hotel, and if we have the report as in the Delhi city, we have around 50% of the out of the complete, like we have four hotels of that with the same name in different location, the four branches of that hotel, and in the Delhi around 50% of the sale is 50% of the turnover is coming from that Delhi location only, right? So it should be accurate within the data. If the data within the Delhi, it's 20%, but here within a report I'm showing it with the 50%. That is not correct, right? So it should be accurate. It should be accurate, like 50% of the turnover is from the Jungle Lounge Hotel that is present within Delhi only. This is something that comes under the accuracy test. Now what about drill down? Let's say if this is for the Delhi location, correct? Now let's say within Delhi only, I want to know how many people are coming from India Pix, how much percentage of people are coming from Make My Trip, how many percentage of people are coming from the like direct they are coming, not from any website. Right, so this thing means firstly we'll move on to Delhi, then within Delhi I am drilling it down to more granular level, like what is the way, like people are coming, people are approaching to that hotel, right? So that thing comes under drilling it down to make it more granular level. Firstly we were just looking at total number of people that are coming in Delhi, in the Delhi location. Now I want to drill it down to the India Bix, to the Make My Trip, and the direct sale. Okay, so what I can write here, 50% of the people are the total in Delhi, let's say from India Bix 30% of the people are coming, from Make My Trip 20%, and 50% are coming directly, right? So this is how we can drill it down. This thing again we do need to test. That is possible if we are doing the functional testing. Functional testing with the drill down report check specifically. Now what about performance check? Performance means if one is creating the report and one person is drilling it down to more granular level. I want to drill it down. Now in how many seconds one is able to view? If I click on that filter that I want to drill it down, like what is the way of people are coming to that hotel, to that city. So it is taking 2 seconds. Now again I want to remove that filter. I again want to come back at the highest level. So that means I don't want to drill it down to that more granular level. So it is again taking back the 3 seconds. So the performance is reducing, right? It is taking 2 seconds to drill down. Now to come back at the highest level, it is taking 3 seconds. So this is how performance can be checked. This is for the within reports. Let's say I'm opening it within the browser, within my account. Then how much time it is taking to open each and every sheet separately? Again, the same thing. Browser check means in which all browser I'm able to view my report. I'm able to view that within the Chrome only or within the that Firefox only. This is about the functional testing. The way the thing that I was saying, we have different kinds of testing that we can perform. Now what about ad hoc testing? Ad hoc, from its name it's clear, ad hoc means on the spot. What we are looking for, are we getting the correct thing or not? Once I click on the area that I want to drill it down to the location, to the Delhi location only, then subject area is for the Delhi location only, I am able to check, yes, it is giving me the correct result. Then I want to look at the So then I want to look at in the more granular level, that I want to view it at the from which, what is the way of coming that the coming that people approaching that hotel, what is the way for that? That thing can be possible if we have the subject area. What is the area that I am getting, like on which subject I am focusing on, right? And next one is mapping check. For sure mapping is required. If I am explaining that we have the data, we have the collected data, this is the data that is present within the target file of that ETL after performing the ETL process, right? So mapping we'll have, we can map, we can view if we are getting the correct thing or not. So this thing can be possible if we have the mapping document. Now what about joins? The thing that I was explaining, Tableau do supports the joins as well. Different types of joins like we have within SQL, within Oracle. In the same way, we have the joins in Tableau. Inner join, outer join, left join, right join. All different kinds of joins we can implement the way that we want to use to view that data. We have one more smart join that is not possible within SQL. That is the blending. This is called as the smart join. On the support joins, can we provide or not? That's why we are getting this joins check. Ad hoc means on the spot, if we are clicking here and there, what we are getting as an output. And the next thing is security. Which all user can view, can access the report? Which all user can view, can download, can change, can only read the data? Is the data security. Single sign-in user, like the thing I said, if I want to open the report only from my account. Okay, so if I am logged in into my account, only then I'll able to view that report. That comes under single sign-on security. Integrated security means for the multiple users. If we are working within the company and I want to share my report with my colleagues, so then it will be called as integrated security. Okay, so these all comes under the security testing. Regression testing is surely performed in the end. Regression means if I made any change after making the prompt check, after looking at the data check, security test, if I make any change, is it working correctly or not? After performing the changes, is it now satisfying my goals or not? My requirements or not? That comes under regression testing. So all kind of testing that we have already performed will be tested again to implement this regression testing. Report database query, if it is performing a performance testing, the testing of prompts, the collected data, the security, okay? And the last one is stress testing. How it is managing if I am opening that from the single user or multiple users are approaching that same report, how it is behave, what is the behavior of that? What is the catch amount for that? Catch means in as a whole, how much amount of data it is having at one time. Measurement means to calculate how it is performing, how it is handling the stress. So these all are the ways to implement all of these kind of testing within the reports only. The way we have ETL testing, the same way we have report testing. Or if I'm saying the report testing, then surely the dashboard testing will come inside that only. Okay, so that's all for today. Next we'll meet I'll show you how to download and install the reporting tool Tableau that we are using, what all are the different versions of Tableau. Okay.